بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمه الله وبركاته. And very good afternoon to all our colleagues, our speakers, and organizing committee, and all the participants of the seminar, as well as going to be a participant on the competition, I hope. So, okay, I'm Muhammad Zain from Department of Architecture, Faculty of the Environment in UTM. My topic today is quite simple, which is energy efficiency in building. I think everybody knows. I'm sure that many of you now in third year, I think, third year architecture, yes? Third year and fourth year, or maybe fifth year. Not only architecture, I thought that also from other departments. Yeah. Okay. So, but my focus will be on buildings, right? So, energy efficiency in building. And roughly, my presentation will touch on explanation about background issues related to energy. So, as I mentioned just now, energy efficiency in building means building that, of course, related to energy. We know that without energy, your building cannot function as what you intend to do. Yeah. So, briefly explain on what is actually energy, energy consumption, and energy demand in today's modern dynamic life, energy use and carbon dioxide emission, which leads to global warming and climate change phenomena. I'm not really sure whether it's already explained or not in this seminar. Is there any explanation this morning? No? Not yet? Okay, I'll touch a bit on this. And then we'll be focusing on energy conservation, energy efficiency concept, and ideas as architectural and building design solution. How will be the energy efficient strategies and technologies can be integrated in building design? And of course, those things actually is towards green building appreciation. So my topic today is a continuation from what Professor Dr. Hamdan already explained to you this morning, I think, which is on the climatic design response. So maybe he touched on more on basic design approach, I hope. And I will be explaining a bit on that and extend it to active design strategies. So it will be a combination of building design responding to climatic architecture design as well as active design. Okay? And as we all understand that we use energy every day. Even if we say that without energy we can't basically live, yeah? Without energy. So the energy we require is for cooking, for lighting, for cooling our home and our environment, as well as in our office. And we need, or we require energy to travel to work or to your campus or to your lecture theater. And indirectly or directly, we use energy in goods that we purchase. You know, your food today that you enjoy this afternoon also require energy to prepare and to be able for you to consume. Energy is a prime source for residential sectors, manufacturing sectors, almost all in our life require energy. And all this actually come from fossil fuel. Well, basically mainly, I would say 95% of world total energy demand is actually from fossil fuel, which is coal, oil and gas generally. Maybe little from what we call power plants, né? From what we call that modern energy today. Eh? So all that's actually for our cooling and heating, cooling for us in a tropical climate and maybe heating in a cold country, for transportation and electricity generation, of course. So if you can see here, for the commercial sectors, manufacturing, transportation and housing, all these require energy to be able to function well. Looking at the global scenario, and maybe all of us aware that since human beings developing non-stop, so many more countries become from poor countries into developing countries and to be a developed country. Malaysia aiming for to become a developed country in 2020, and Melaka, Bandaraya Bersejarah now change into Melaka Bandaraya Maju. See? So these activities require, of course, energy, and as mentioned here, it is predicted that in 2030, energy will increase by 66% compared to the demand in the year 2000. Especially in the Asian region, that particularly Malaysia, we are developing quite consistently. Yeah? So the requirement of energy is really increasing every day. And if you look at the compared to the GDP, our gross domestic product, is actually in tandem with the energy demand or energy requirement. So this is a graph showing the electricity sale compared to GDP. Means our quality of life increase require more energy for our development, for our people. So because of this, of course, mainly is actually from the fossil fuel burning in the electricity generation, and as well as in industrial processes, locally or globally. So that increase dramatically the amount of carbon emission in the Earth atmosphere, and it is unavoidable. So with that as well, as we know, by burning fossil fuel, carbon dioxide will be emitted to the environment. And from the scientific reference that we can say is that approximately 280 parts per million by volume to reach 377 parts per million volume. This is basically the situation that we everybody should wear, and we as a designer, particularly architect and engineer, should aware about this and what is actually the consequences when we design something that's not really energy efficient in mind. So that will create global warming, and we know that the consequences of global warming will become the phenomena that what we call as climate change. What is climate change? It means that the mean sea level is expected to raise between 9 to 88 centimeters by the year 2100, causing flood and even will change the environment extremely, and will disrupt the forest, desert, and many more. And this situation we see, you know, from time to time, and even in our own country, Malaysia, for example, this phenomena already happened, and everybody talk about global warming already this Malaysia. So what is actually initiative? Either globally or nationally, as well as at local and institutional level, there are two initiatives focusing on this facing the global warming and climate change, which is how can we reduce the energy consumption or energy demand.